The week started with Parliament's request to the Prime Minister Robina Nabanja to step up regulations on the mushrooming DNA paternity laboratories in the country to avoid cases of fake results that threaten to break families. Parliament is concerned with surging cases of DNA tests done by doubting fathers on their children.
I think we need to guide the nation. Right, Honourable Prime Minister, you need to come out, you guide the nation. Because what is going on, you know, innocent children are falling victims. Now you don't know what your parents were doing, you don't know what happened. All of a sudden you see someone saying, stop using my name. Someone is saying, bring back your national ID.
And we add the DNA test to that restricted list, so that it is only done on a court order or to solve the problem. We want to save the mental health of our children and of the men who are now committing suicide. It's not adding value to the economy.
Why is it that now men, us, including me, are complaining when we are looking after the children?
The House has also tasked the National Water and Sewage Corporation to expedite investigations into inflated water bills. This was after adopting a report by the Committee on Commissions, Statutory Authorities and State Enterprises COSASE, which investigated complaints from the public that National Water and Sewage Corporation estimates their bills and charges exorbitantly without proper justification.
And because this corporation is not competing with any other, we might not encourage them to be proactive. So I propose that the minister in charge should look at bringing the digital component of bidding in the same organization.
Still this week, we saw Parliament directing the Minister of Health to settle a debt of 31.4 billion shillings owed to the national medical stores. This was after a debate on the report on COSASE on NRM in regard to queries raised by the Auditor General on the financial statements of National Medical Stores for the financial year that ended June 2022.
The accounting officer of the Ministry of Health, in conjunction with the Ministry of Finance, should settle all the outstanding arrears to NMS within 6 months from the date of adoption of this report.
Why should health get money from finance and then they refuse to give money to NMS to procure drugs? Then again, we are going to go back to amend the law that they should get their money directly, but they are supervised by Minister of Health.
Tax bills are also getting stuck in the Finance Committee of Parliament as government seeks to collect 5 billion shillings from the proposed income tax on non-residential digital companies like Facebook, Twitter, Amazon and others. It is also seeking approval of Parliament to extend the corporate income tax waiver for Bujagali Energy Limited for 1 year. In revenue amounting to 95.6 billion shillings will be foregone.
We don't grant the waiver. That means the tax would be collected. And it would be the same tax that we want to waive. And already, if we are to keep with principle, there was already a resolution by Parliament that this does not happen.
There is corporate income tax. So when you block in the current practice, according to the agreement, that CIT is zero because of the waiver they have been providing. So the argument they are saying is that if a figure goes there, then the tariff will go up. It's a technical argument because of the formula, which we thought was very ridiculous.
In another landmark decision, Parliament resolved to increase the number of High Court judges from the current 83 to 151 after agreeing with Justice and Constitutional Affairs Minister Honorable Norbert Mao on the need for higher numbers on the bench to ease case backlog.
Family courts have so many cases. The intention of government is to increase access to judicial services.
The Trade Committee has been a center of counter accusations as former officials came out on Monday and pinned the permanent secretary of the ministry, Geraldine Sally, for flouting procurement rules. But the ministry came out on Thursday and disputed wild allegations on procurement of used cars, among others.
Government gave the ministry money to purchase new vehicles for the ministers and the PS, 5 vehicles. It has now come to our attention that these vehicles they procured were used. They bought them from a bond in Nakawa. And now we are trying to establish information as to how they came to this decision, because each vehicle was procured at 600 million shillings.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.